So something that first-time RV buyers are afraid of or intimidated by is backing up a trailer. Some people have never backed up a trailer, period, in their lives, or they've never backed up a trailer of this size. On RV forums and RV Facebook groups, the advice that's always given that I see time and time again is to go to an open parking lot, set up some cones, and practice. It's good and all, but what exactly do you practice? I'm lucky enough that I have access to a large open parking lot area, so I'm gonna run this truck and this trailer through the basic backing maneuvers used for Class A CDL testing. We're gonna wonder, why am I going to show parallel parking when it's something you're probably never going to use? You probably won't ever use it, but what it will do is build confidence in your skill of backing a trailer. So the first thing that we're going to go through or explain is tail swing. Tail swing is the amount of the back end of the trailer that comes out when you make a sharp turn. It's usually 1 foot of tail swing for every 3 feet of trailer behind the axles. So the center line of the axles all the way back to the back bumper. That part of the trailer is going to swing out when you make a sharp turn. To demonstrate this, I have stopped the truck and the trailer right on this yellow line. Lynn is in the truck, and I'm going to have her turn the wheel sharp right and pull forward until I tell her to stop. When she stops, we will see how much of this trailer is hanging over the line.
Now you're right.
Okay, so from this point, you can see how much of this trailer is now hanging over the line to the left side just by making a right-hand turn. As she continues forward, the back end of the trailer will continue to stay to the left side of this line. This is something that you have to be careful of if you go into a gas station. If you're up close to the pump and then you fill up with gas or diesel and then you go to pull away, the back end of the trailer could and most likely will contact a stationary object like a gas pump, a car, a concrete post. Okay, I'm gonna put it in gear. I'm gonna have you continue forward.
Continue to be cranked all
the way to the right? Yeah. Going forward. Straighten the wheels up. That's good. Okay, so behind me I have a lane set up. These cones, they are all set 12 feet apart from each other. This lane is about 100 feet long. This is going to be the straight line back. The straight line backing sounds pretty basic, pretty easy, but you'd be surprised how many people struggle with this. The idea is to back in a straight line from the start of the cones all the way down to the end till your front bumper clears the end. Okay, so do the straight line back from inside the truck. What you want to do, obviously, is keep an eye on your mirrors on both sides. As you back up,
put one hand on the top of the wheel. And what you're gonna do is drive straight back through the cones. With your hand at the top of the wheel, if the trailer starts to drift one way or the other, left or right, you'll steer towards the problem. So for example, I'm gonna let the trailer come out to the left a little bit. Okay, so now the trailer is going out to the left. So with one hand at the top of the wheel, I'm gonna steer towards that problem. As I back up, the problem will correct itself. When you're in a straight line again with the trailer, get the truck back in line with the trailer. Nothing to it. Just watch your mirrors on both sides as you back through. Again, I'm steering towards the problem and keeping the truck in a straight line with the trailer. I'm only making small movements in the steering wheel, to the left and to the right, maybe a quarter to half turn, no more than that. Once we are all the way through the lane, that completes that maneuver. Okay, so I've moved the cones around and I've reset them to do what's called the reverse lane change. So we've got two lanes here. I'm gonna start way up there. Got three cones up there to mark the two lanes. Those cones are about 140 feet from these cones back here where Lynn is standing. To make it a little easier for you guys to see what I'm doing, I place these markers on the ground. This marker indicates the center line from the center cone up there to the center line back here. I figure it'll just show up better on video when I do it that way. So I'm going to start up here in the right lane and I'm going to back into the left lane back here. Okay, back in the truck. Might be able to see the cones back there in the mirror for the lane change. We are in the right lane. Put the truck in reverse. I'm gonna turn to the right because I want the trailer to go left. Now, a lot of these maneuvers you do, imagine the nose of the truck is pointing at 12 o'clock noon. Depending on which way you turn the wheel, you only want to back up to set enough angle to where the nose of the truck is either pointing at 11 o'clock or 1 o'clock. So it's not a whole lot. So I'm going to turn to the right and I'm going to back up because we're going into the left lane. Okay, so that right there should be pretty close to 11 o'clock. So I'm going to turn the wheel all the way to the left so I can get straightened back up with the trailer again. Once I'm straight with the trailer, I'm going to stop and see where I'm at. Looks perfect. So I'm going to continue back in a straight line. So I'm just going to straighten my wheels out back up in a straight line. I'm not sure if the camera can pick it up or not, but you can see that marker I put on the ground. What I'm looking for is for the trailer axles to get to that marker, which is right about there. Once the axles are at that marker, I'm going to turn left and I'm going to back up until my drive axles get back there by that marker. Okay, drive axles are right on that marker. So now I want to get straight in line with the trailer again. So I'm going to turn all the way to the right. Okay, now I am straight in the lane. Plenty of room to spare on this side. Again, these cones are set 12 feet apart. So I'm going to continue to back up while watching my mirrors in this lane. This is, again, just straight line backing. And we are in the lane. So now I'm going to pull forward all the way up. I'm going to do the reverse lane change from the left lane to the right lane. Okay, we are all the way up to the front. The truck is in reverse. You can see that we are in the left lane on both sides. So we're going from the left lane to the right lane. So I'm going to turn the wheel all the way to the left. Remember, we're going for either 11 o'clock or 1 o'clock. So in this case, we're going to the 1 o'clock position, roughly. It'll put you in the ballpark. We'll turn the wheel all the way back to the right so we can get straight in line with the trailer. Okay, right there, we're straight in line with the trailer. So this is where I'm going to straighten my wheels out. I'm going to continue to back straight up. All right. So my trailer axles are at the marker. I'm going to turn to the right because I want the trailer to come out to the left. Back up until my drive axles get to that marker. So we're out there now, so I'm going to turn left and get back in front of my trailer. Okay, we're in a straight line. And we are well within the boundaries. So I'm going to straighten the wheels out and continue to back into this lane. Nothing to it. It's either 11 o'clock or 1 o'clock. Okay, so the next maneuver I've set up is parallel parking. Something you probably never use, but hey, how many people can say I know how and have parallel parked my camper? So the way that this is set up, again, these cones up here in the front, so you got this cone is 12 feet to that cone, 12 feet to that cone, and so on. I put a cone in the middle to designate the center of the parallel park spot. The parallel park spot is 12 feet wide, and it's the length of the vehicle plus 15 feet. So we are up ahead of the parallel spot. You can probably see it back there in the mirror. What we're going to do is back up in a straight line. Once that first cone on the outside corner gets up by the trailer axles, we're going to go ahead and stop. We're going to start by turning away from the parallel spot. Parallel spot's on the right, so we're going to turn to the left. We're going to back up to set our angle. It's either 11 o'clock or 1 o'clock. So we're going to back up to where approximately at 1 o'clock. At that point, turn all the way back to the right, get back in line with the camper. Again, I put the markers on the ground so that it shows up on the camera at what point we're turning the wheel. So I'm going to go straight back until the trailer axles get to that line. Okay, trailer axles are at that line, so we are going to turn to the right. Because the back end of the trailer is already in the parallel spot, now we have to get the nose over into the parallel spot. So turn into the right, and backing up. So you can see that the drive axle is coming up on that line. So I'm going to turn back to the left because the trailer is in the parallel spot. I have to get the truck in. So by turning to the left, the nose of the truck is going to come over. Now the front of the truck is out of bounds a little bit. I'm just going to turn to the right and pull forward. And we're in. Okay, parallel parking again, except this time it's on the driver's side. Now normally you'd think it's gonna be a lot easier because it is on the driver's side. But to be honest, parallel parking on the blind side when it's on the right or passenger side is easier. Because as you come into the parallel spot on the driver's side, you need to watch out your right hand or passenger side mirror. It's gonna be the same thing as before. Just gonna back up in a straight line until that cone is next to your trailer axles. When you get to that point, we're going to turn away from the parallel spot. The parallel spot is on the left, so we're going to turn to the right. We're gonna back up and set our angle so the nose of the truck is about 11 o'clock. Right about there. And turn the wheel back all the way to the left so we can get straightened up with our trailer again. All right. So now you can see the two cones at the back of the parallel spot. We're going to back up in a straight line until our tires get to those markers on the ground. Again, those markers indicate the open side of the box from the outside cone at the front to the outside cone at the back. Now that our trailer tires are crossing that line, we're going to turn to the left. Because the back end of the trailer is in the parallel spot, we have to get the nose pushed over into the parallel spot. So now our drive axle is at that marker that indicates the line from the outside cone to the outside cone, and the trailer is in the spot. I can show you here. So we're going to turn the wheel back to the left so we can get lined up in front of our trailer again. Oh, I'm sorry, back to the left? I meant back to the right. I was looking backwards when I said that. So we turn the wheel to the right. We're in the parallel spot. I'm going to turn to the left and pull forward. And that's all there is to it. We are now in the parallel spot.
The next maneuver that I have set up is called the alley dock. We start out at 90 degrees and we back in to these cones down here. You can think of this like backing into a campsite, although at a campground you're going to have a whole lot less room to maneuver. But that's why when you practice, you pick a place like this, where you've got all the room you need. When you're in a campground, the pressure's going to be on a little more. You have less room. You're going to feel like everyone is watching you and judging you. But how I have these set up, these cones out here, all 12 feet apart, which I'll show you. And then we've got this row of cones up here. So these cones up here are set about 70 feet from these cones. Like I said, it's a lot more room than you'll ever have in a campground, and it's a lot more room than you need. But when you're practicing, you need to build your confidence up. You need to learn how to do these maneuvers without fear of hitting anything. So these are 12 feet wide. And then back here, we've got these cones. These two cones, we have to stop where the bumper is between those without hitting that center cone. A good thing to do when you're backing up, if you are unsure of what's behind your trailer or on the blind side of your trailer, get out and look, or goal, G-O-A-L, get out and look. It's always better to get out and look than hit something.
Okay, starting out in the truck, you probably see the you can see the alley dock back there. You see those cones set up. We are set up basically in the middle between the alley dock, or the mock campsite we'll call it, and the boundary cones, which are over on this side. So we're going to start out by turning the wheel slightly to the right, maybe a full turn, maybe. You're gonna back up a couple more feet, set some angle on that trailer. So now that the trailer is angled out to the side, we're gonna straighten the wheels out. All we want is to have the steer tires straightened out, because as we back up in a straight line, that trailer is going to continue to drift over towards the mock campsite. As we back up, I have to do some steering wheel adjustment. I got it turned just a little bit to the left. We want to stay out in front of that, that alley dock. Okay, now that the back end of the trailer is about in line with the alley dock, I'm going to turn all the way to the right. Now, if you can't remember, or you start to panic a little bit and you can't remember which way to turn the wheel to make the trailer do what you want it to do, look at the back of the tire. If the back of the tire is out to the left, the trailer is going to go to the left. If the back of the trailer is facing to the right, the trailer is going to go right. But right now we want it to go left, so I got the wheel turned to the left. I got quite a bit more angle on the trailer, so I'm going to straighten the wheels out. That's basically what you're going to have to do when you're backing into a site, is turn the wheel to the right and straighten the wheels. Turn the wheel to the right and straighten the wheels. And my wheels are still straight. Now I'm going to turn to the right. As you can see how the trailer axles are lined up with that first cone in the corner. So I'm going to turn all the way right, back up and put some more angle on it, straighten the wheels out. Now at this point, you can see that the back end of the trailer is in the alley dock, or the campsite. So I'm going to turn the wheel all the way to the left so I can get back in front of the trailer again. Again, my wheels are all the way to the left. Okay, the trailer is basically lined up in that spot, so I need to get straightened out. I'm gonna turn the wheel to the right and pull forward. Okay, now I'm lined up pretty good. I'm just gonna watch here in the mirror. The trailer is now lined up in the spot. Turn left. Get back in front of the trailer. And it was maybe 3/4 of a turn in the steering wheel. Last thing you want to do is turn the wheel all the way to the left or all the way to the right when you need small adjustments on your trailer. So we're going back straight up. Remember, the bumper has to be between those cones. So I'm going to get out and look and see how close I am. When in doubt, get out and look. Okay, so we can go back a couple more feet. right, I think. Looks good to me. Yep, we're in. Nothing to it.
Well, I hope that helped. Best thing to do is just get out into a parking lot and practice, practice, practice. The other bit of advice that I always see given is to have a spotter and establish some hand signals, or to get a set of two-way radios. I have one of these, a professional Motorola radio, not quite your Walmart FRS radio. The problem I see with spotters is, well, first off, I never use a spotter. Sometimes Lynn will get out just to tell me when to stop when I'm backing up on the leveling blocks. Otherwise, I think spotters just add frustration. Spotter in the back might not exactly know how to maneuver a trailer or how they handle when you're backing. A spotter will tell you to go one way when you know in your head you need to go the other way. First thing I do when I pull up the back into a campsite is I have a plan in my head. I know my plan of attack and how I'm going to back into it. A spotter isn't a mind reader. A lot of people depend solely on a spotter to tell them what to do. I think it's best if you learn how to back a trailer properly and just have a spotter stand by to tell you to stop if you're going to hit something.